that being so, perhaps...
Yeah. Yes.
Madam.
Yes,
Madam Ombudsman, that being so, perhaps it would be better if we will just mark the PowerPoint presentation in evidence and to dispense with your reading of the details, because you might be overly taxed by that, and I don't think it's necessary, because the senator judges can examine the contents of the report yourself.
He is saying something.
Your Honor, please. Yes. I'm not clear with the manifestation made by the Honorable Counsel for the prosecution, Your Honor, which is the evidence ought to be marked. The representations made on the screen, the origin of these representations, or what? We wanted to be clear, Your Honor, before we go into further questioning the witness in connection with them.
Why don't you agree? If you want to use the document presented yesterday by the Ombudsman, which is allegedly the report of AMLA, as the document to be presented here as an exhibit, but on the other hand, this power presentation is now a part of the testimony of the Ombudsman. And so this court would be interested to have a copy of this document.
The source of all this power representation, Your Honor?
Yeah.
I'm just asking for a clarification. I'm
not objecting. Actually, these are actually culled, if I understood the Ombudsman correctly, culled from the records.
Submitted.
That she submitted yesterday and marked as an exhibit by the prosecution.
Yes, Your Honor.
Am I correct in this?
Yes, Your Honor.
Your Honor?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yeah. So
I was puzzled because the documents shown to the witness yesterday, we already marked, Your Honor.
Precisely.
So I was trying to clarify only. I'm not objecting, Your Honor.
Precisely, the Ombudsman, my understanding of what happened was the Ombudsman testified, and in the course of her testimony referred to a report of AMLA, which became the basis of her letter, if I understood correctly, requiring the Chief Justice to reply in 72 hours. And that was the subject of the examination in chief of the Defense Counsel, whether the Ombudsman informed the Chief Justice about the $10 million dollar deposit allegedly owned by him. And at that point, the matter was resolved, and then the counsel closed his direct examination of the Ombudsman, and the prosecution took over to cross-examine, and at that point they have marked, actually the prosecution marked the alleged report of AMLA presented and testified to by the Ombudsman before this court, and the Honorable Ombudsman requested the permission of this court if she could explain further the contents of that alleged report of AMLA by way of showing us a power presentation of the movement of the monies reflected in that report of AMLA. Am I correct in this, Madam?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ombudsman. Yeah. That's
yes, Your
that's
Honor.
The whole gist of the testimony of the Ombudsman. Yeah. And that's why this chair requested that this court be provided with a hard copy of the power presentation and the defense also requested a copy, a hard copy of the power presentation, and thereafter the prosecution also requested a hard copy of the power presentation. So all of us requested a copy of the power presentation.
Clarified, Your Honor.
All right.
If Your Honor, please, the PowerPoint presentation.
PowerPoint. I'm sorry, I'm not literate enough in these things, you know. PowerPoint presentation. Okay.
If Your Honor, please, the PowerPoint presentation that has been made and is still being made by the Honorable Ombudsman is entitled Analysis of Dollar Account, consisting of 25 slides. I confirm with the clerk of court that the senator judges have each been furnished with copies of this so-called analysis of dollar account. And the copy which has been handed to me by the Honorable Ombudsman, each page bears the stamp, certified true copy, deputy clerk of court, the impeachment proceedings, and there are initials, there's one initial over each stamp of deputy clerk of court. May we request that this be marked as exhibit 11Y for the prosecution, Your Honor?
Mark it accordingly.
Madam Ombudsman, you testified a few minutes ago in reply to the query of the presiding judge that $769,681 were withdrawn from an account of the Chief Justice in the month of December 2011. You confirm that?
Yes, sir.
Can you advise us or tell us how much was withdrawn from December 12 forward?
No more. It did not go back anymore. I mean, the data that was sourced did no longer indicated where that 769,000 plus went.
So you won't be able to tell if it was done on December 12?
December 15.
15?
Yes.
I see. So that amount of 769,681 was withdrawn on December 15.
Yes.
You testified yesterday that there were significant accounts with respect to certain significant events. Do you recall that, Madam Ombudsman?
Yes, sir.
Can you clarify what you meant by that?
Well, what I meant was that there were significant deposits and withdrawals on significant events. When I say events, I am referring to, let's say, 2004 election, 2007 election, and during the period onset of the impeachment proceedings.
For the elections of 2004, Madam Ombudsman, which you consider to be a significant event, what was the corresponding significant figure?
Let me look at my código.
Beg Your Honor, the question do not appear clear to us. May we request for a reforming of the question, Your Honor?
No,
let me have my copy of
What is vague about it?
Well, there are various incidents mentioned in the question, Your Honor. We would like to know what is the gist of the question, Your Honor.
Will the gentleman of the prosecution repeat the question so that we will understand the nature of the objection?
I asked, Mr. President, what were the significant periods pertaining to the significant events which the Honorable Ombudsman mentioned? What are the figures?
She mentioned
election.
The election of 2004.
That's right, Your Honor.
And then the impeachment filed in this court.
Yes, Your Honor. And the elections in 2007.
And then the election in 2007, yes.
Yes, and I'm just asking the witness when she said that there were significant amounts pertaining to a significant event, what are these amounts? I think that's very clear. Yeah. In fact, the witness has not said the question is vague.
Let the witness answer.
Yes, sir. In May 12, there was a...
May 12 when, Your Honor?
2014. No, rather, 2004, there was a deposit of 500... Where is my... I had a deposit of 500,000 at the PI Bank of PI Acropolis. On May 14, 2004, yes,
that was dollars.
We're all talking of dollars.
All right, thank you.
Dollar is spoken in other words. On May 14, there was a deposit of $500,000.
May I ask this question to clarify? Just so, is there any showing who made the deposit into that?
There is none, Your
deposit
Honor.
Account.
Maybe it's only the banks which can determine who made
the records
deposit.
Of the bank would show.
Maybe, Your Honor.
By the way, are these deposit accounts interest-bearing deposits?
I suppose so, Your Honor.
And there must
some,
be,
some
there
are
must be a record of withholding of the 20% final tax.
The bank would be able to enlighten us on the matter, Your Honor, because we have no documents to back up this record of transactions.
Yes, please go ahead.
Then, yes, I'm looking at 2007. Can I have my magnifying lens? On 2007, on May 3, there was a deposit of 293,645.23 at the Bank of Philippine Islands in San Francisco del Monte. On May 3.
By the way, do we know the exchange rate at that time, Madam? If these are in dollars,
I
what
don't
would
know,
be the
Your
equivalent
Honor.
Amounts in pesos?
Thank you. I don't know, Your Honor, but I think at the time the exchange rate was much higher than the present rate of exchange now. All right. On May 3, 2007, there was a deposit at the BPI against San Francisco del Monte branch in the amount of 25,039.0. No, rather.
Can you say that again, madam?
25,250,000. Where are we? On May 3, 2007, there was a deposit of 27,039.80 at the Bank of Philippine Islands, San Francisco del Monte. On May 3 again, there was a deposit of 134,603.28 again at the BPI San Francisco del Monte. On May 3, there was a deposit of 63,345.61 at the BPI SFDM. And on